The Young and the Restless.
I look at the script the night before, or the afternoon before, in between doing other scenes, on the show the day before. And I look at it quickly, and I go through it, and I say, wait a minute, this should be maybe okay, then uh-huh. And in that process, I already understand the scene, what it's about, and then I say, okay. Then I put it aside, because I'm still working on that day's show. And then the next morning, when I go to work, we have about an hour, hour and a half of blocking and really looking at it. Then I really start paying attention. And I said, okay, let me say, go back to the top again. Okay. You begin to understand and you begin to feel the scene as you do it. You begin to feel it, you begin to sense it. And it's a whole amalgam of reactions in you. Intellectual understanding, emotional identification with it, very important. That's why Shakespeare is so difficult, because you first need to understand the language. For example, Richard III, now is the winter of our discontent, made glorious summer by the sun of York. And all the clouds that lured upon our house in the deep bosom of the ocean buried. That image, that language is fantastic. Now, instead of mounting barbed steeds to fright the souls of fearful adversaries, he capers nimbly in a lady's chamber to the lascivious pleasing of a lute. He talks about his brother getting laid upstairs after a successful battle. Oh, the language of Shakespeare. But you need to understand it first. So most of Shakespeare is wasted on the normal audience, even an educated audience. To really understand it, you have to almost go through it line by line. And so you learn that in what I do every day. You understand it quickly, and then you begin to emotionally understand it. And so it's a combination of intellectual and emotional understanding.